Like, could you look at me with that sparkle in your eye? I've got one chance to take you back, otherwise I'll lay down and die. According to you, according to you, I just lay down and die.
I can't just do one thing. That's why I think I do so many things. Because, I don't know, I just feel like if you're talented at a few things, why not make money from them? I think that's the best thing. But I never thought that I would be doing all these things. I think when I was growing up, when I was younger, I couldn't sing, I couldn't act or anything like that. I didn't want to be a doctor. I didn't want to be, you know, I didn't want to work any of those type of jobs. So I didn't think I was talented at anything.
Oh my God, this was my corner shop. It's gone.
Oh no.
This is like, it's to come and buy Pokemon cards.
All of us are doing it.
Oh my God.
All of us that lived in that
only
block.
Boys in my school.
Yeah, I loved it. I absolutely loved it. I was a little bit of a tomboy though, but.
Me too.
Because I was like with my dad as well, most of the time. I used to just be very, very rough. Just on smoke, yeah, playing loads of sports. I used to like running. I used to like football. Like all of the sports, I used to love it. Riding. I remember me and my brother used to literally ride to Chelsea. There was an adventure playground that we used to ride to. Like, I was just all about the fun and the arts and crafts, basically. So with styling, I started that while I was still at uni, but I was also a radio presenter. Ooh. So I used to co-host a show on Pulse 88, it's a station in North Wembley. While I was at uni, when we would like do shoots and stuff, everyone would always want to borrow my clothes. I would be like the go-to, but it didn't occur to me that that could actually be a job. Mm-hmm. Like I could get paid to dress people for music videos. It was very bizarre when I found out and I realized that, wow, like this is actually a job. So yeah, the first ever music video I did was for an artist that was one of the first guests on the radio show. So he actually asked me and Shayna, who I was hosting with, to be in the video. And then I basically styled myself, Shayna, and the other girl that was in the video. And that was literally like my first job. They were literally all here, the blocks I used to live, all over here. Crazy! Well, it's called Taomi Road, I lived at 135. It was right behind here. I think the last time I came here was maybe like over 5 or 6 years ago and they were still here. But it looks like, yeah.
Were they working on them then?
I don't think so, they were still there. They were still here for quite some time. But they've knocked them bitches down. It's so weird to be here.
Okay,
so you can see what
you're looking at. Yeah, that was it. Madness. What happened here? They had been abandoned. Crazy. So they were built in the 80s.
Tenants in the Sands End were being forced out of their homes, and 80 homes will be bulldozed. And that was in 2008. See, I haven't been here for time. That must have been a good 10 years that I've come back here. Okay, 10 years ago. Wow. Crazy. Both of my parents that were living there with my younger brother. And yeah, my mum and dad were going through their problems. My mum and dad broke up. My mum basically got addicted to drugs, so like hard drugs, like crack. I don't really know the ins and outs. I remember things going missing from the house. Like my dad would always like buy us stuff because we'd go stay with our dad on the weekend. He would buy us stuff and clothes and whatever. And it's basically she was like selling everything. Sometimes we'd go stay at our grandma's and she would literally leave us there for weeks. But at the time we didn't know what was going on. There was a friend that she had, I remember, there was this Scottish guy. He had a daughter she was a baby, and we were really close. She was a lot younger than me, but I really loved this little girl. And then I remember one time he literally injected right in front of me, because I remember in school as well. So we were coming to, me and my little brother were coming to school, and obviously I think the teachers knew what was going on, because before we would be well presented, you know, my hair would always be done, me and my brother would all be fine, but she was literally sending us to school looking crazy. I was quite naughty, and it makes sense why, because I was just kind of lashing out. So she's obviously gone to social services and said that, right, like, she doesn't want to look after us, she doesn't want us because it's too much. So my dad has basically had to go to court for us, which was mad. We never went to court. She didn't turn up to any of the court hearings. All I knew is basically my mum didn't want me. That was it. So my mum basically abandoned us. Like, she tried to come and see us a few times, but I used to get really emotional. But my brother, he would always be happy to see my mum. But I was just so angry at her for doing that, for leaving us.
Mm-hmm.
I just used to get so upset, and I just refused to see her. Okay, this is how, yeah, okay, at primary school.
Mm-hmm.
The reason why my teeth are dented in, my two front teeth, is because I was giving a piggyback to one of my friends, and I fell on my teeth. And now my teeth have been fucked ever since. This is where it happened.
Wow. Memories.
I ain't been back here since I left. In whatever year that was.
What did you want to be when you were older, when you were at primary school?
Okay, so I always wanted to have my own clothing line.
Mm-hmm.
But then, like, it changed quite a lot. I remember I wanted to be a forensic scientist. I wanted to be a judge and a barrister. I had so many things, crazy ideas, but I did always wanted to do fashion. I knew I wanted to have my own clothes. Like, being a little girl, and obviously your mum abandoning you, like, you need your mum as a little girl, so, you know, you need your mum in life. I don't have a relationship with my mother at all. And then a couple of years ago, finally, I was kind of just like, not over it, but I was able to deal with it a bit better. And I didn't realise that that experience had made me the way I am and act certain ways, abandonment issues. So that really translated in relationships and stuff like that.
Yeah.
As soon as I identified that, I was able to kind of heal from it and move forward. I'm thankful my journey has been crazy. Yeah, I didn't really have support from my parents, so everything I've kind of done has literally just been off my own back. Yeah, I wouldn't change any of it, because I wouldn't be how I am and who I am.
Returnees, can you make some noise if you've been to Girl Gang before, please?
Girl Gang is a platform for women, but community for everybody. Some of the ladies that I've discovered in the time of me doing it is mad. Like, I've literally found all these amazing girls. They've gone on to do amazing things.
Girl Gang performers shut it down.
Okay. It creates a lot of opportunities. That's basically what Girl Gang is. It's created so much opportunities, and it's been like over 200 girls that have performed and have taken part.
This is Girl Gang. So all of those feelings that you might have as well, leave them at the door. This is a very, very friendly and loving space.
Yeah, I'm so proud of it. And like, if anybody that knows Girl Gang comes, they'll know that like the vibes are just unmatched. Like, the energy is just on another level. Like, it's a reflection of me as well. It's like, it's my child. Because Naomi, she's really shy and she like doesn't like hosting, even though she runs this amazing event, giving a platform to women in music. But it would be amazing if you come forward.
Well, guys, are we feeling Tiana?
Yeah!
Did she come with an E? Did she come with a fire? Did she come with the flames?
Yeah!
Okay, that was the opening act, yeah? Tell a friend to tell a friend. That was the opening act, yeah?
She ain't changed. some things don't change. I remember this red thing. Crazy.
Look at the doll.
The clown. These are so popular back in the day. I collect all these weird little pendants.
Oh, I love those.
With the nails, I started that basically lockdown. If I do say so myself, I'm sick. I'm one of the best. I did a course, but acrylic wasn't actually on my course. So I basically taught myself. And I wasn't even going to, I was gonna complete the course, then I was gonna start practicing, and then I was gonna start doing it. But it's like the lockdown forced me to do it. And even one of my close friends, Kelsey, she was like, no, you need to start selling press-ons. And at first I was like, that is so fucking long, like, I ain't got time for that. But then it was like, well, I'm not making any money. I can't do styling right now. Can't do girl gang. Can't do any photography or any other stuff that I'm involved in. So, you know, what can I do? And I literally started it. Started selling press-ons. I literally like posted stuff on TikTok as well. I got like clients from TikTok, Instagram, and I literally just started building it like that. It's kind of like a full circle thing, because growing up I was really interested in like drawing and painting. I loved art, and I haven't really done anything like that for a long time. I want to do Missy Elliott's nails. I want to do Rihanna's nails. And there's this really cool artist called Rosalia. She has the most long, amazing nails. I need to do her nails. And literally everybody whose nails I do, they say this is the best nails I've ever done. That's like the best feeling. Yeah, I love doing nails so much, because I'm just able to be so creative. It's been a crazy journey, man, and I just can't wait to see in 5 years time like how good I am. Should I wear it, should I not? The guys go crazy for the blondes. If I dress in heels just once, usually don't. Please just give me your approval. The furry coat goes with the boots, so boots, so. Maybe sort of like